Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tony D'Angelo, and welcome to my home. Today we have a request to make homemade macaroni. I'm very excited about this because I used to make this all the time with my grandmother when I was just a little kid. It's very easy, it's a lot of fun, and it tastes 1,000 times better than the stuff you get that's been processed in some factory someplace far away. Let's take a quick rundown of our ingredients. Okay, the first thing we're going to need is a mixing bowl. We're going to need 1/2 tablespoon of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of milk, 1/4 tablespoon of salt, 3 eggs, and 2 cups of all-purpose flour. The first thing we're going to do is combine our olive oil our 3 eggs, our milk, and our salt. Okay, once we have it all mixed up there, we put that aside for now, and we're going to come over to our table. Okay, guys, we've thoroughly cleaned our hands and our table. We're just going to take our, and everything's nice and dry. Dry is important here. We're going to take our flour, 2 cups, bump it right there. This is one of my favorite recipes because, yeah, you guessed it, you get to play with your food. We're going to make like a little volcano here. It's really important that your hands are dry and your tabletop's dry, which is tough because you're always going to want to clean everything before you do it. Then you got to kind of chill out and wait. Okay, we got a little volcano there. We're going to start to pour in the middle our eggs. Don't go too quick with this. Then you just kind of fold it in on itself. Oh, we're getting away. That's where it gets fun. Yeah, I could use the KitchenAid mixer for this, but this is a lot more fun to do it by hand. Kind of, it's a little bit more traditional too, but you know, it won't hurt it if you use a mixer. Okay, after a few minutes of rolling it around, you pretty much get it like this. Then what you want to do is break it up into about 3 sections. Okay guys, we have our pasta machine set up. It's clamped down to our table. We've cut our dough into 3 balls. We've got a pasta machine set on the widest gap it has. And it takes a little bit of time to do this, but it's kind of fun. First thing we're going to do, is roll our pasta through. Okay, then we're going to take our pasta out like this. Fold the sides in on it. Run it through again. Not a quick process, but and what we do is we move it in a notch, just 1 notch at a time, and run it through again. That's getting a little bit long to deal with, so I'm going to take about half of that. Shut her down another notch. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to continue this process, shutting it down 1 notch at a time. Or at least, you want to go through at least once on every setting. You've
heard the expression being run through the mill. There you go. Yeah, we're not done yet. Now we put our cutting attachment on and we cut it up. Today we're going to make linguine, which is the thicker of the two this machine can make. If you're just starting out, I recommend you start with that till you get used to it. You always want to put a little bit of flour on your cutting wheel. Helps things go a little better. Okay guys, here's the deal. We've run all the noodles through our cutter and we've spread them out on our table, mixing them with a little bit of flour to keep them from sticking together. Here's where you make or break this one. If you put them in a big pile after you cut them, you end up with one big noodle. You're going to spread them out as much as you can, room providing, and a little bit of flour to keep them mixed up. I'm going to let this sit for about 2 hours. I'm going to cover it with a towel just so nothing gets on it, but in about 2 hours we'll be ready to cook it. Okay folks, we've brought a pot of water, two-thirds of this pot, to a boil. In the water we've added a quarter teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of olive oil. Now we're going to add in our noodles. We're going to give that a nice gentle stir. You have to be a little bit more careful with the homemade pasta. If you don't treat it proper, it'll stick together pretty bad. Cover up. Let it go for about 8 minutes. Okay, it's been about 7 or 8 minutes. And our macaroni's done. What we're going to do now is turn the heat off and drain the contents through our colander in our sink. I hope this doesn't fog up the lens. I know it just looks like spaghetti to you, but it's homemade macaroni. You made it yourself. You took flour and eggs, a little old rinse of cold water there. Oh yeah. You took flour, eggs, salt, mixed it up. You went to the trouble to cut it. It'll go really good with your homemade meatballs. Okay, gentlemen. I know it's a lot easier to open a package of this than to do what you just did. But how much can you brag about opening a package of this? Right. As soon as somebody asks, I'll show you how to make the gravy. That's what we Italians call the spaghetti sauce. God bless you. Thank you for watching. As always, we cannot thank the subscribers and the viewers enough. You are the reason we do it. And remember, even tough guys can cook.